Y'all, I linked up with Good Job Larry before his set at Lollapalooza in Chicago. The Bay Area artist gave us a few clues for his upcoming project and why he only works 3 hours a day.
What are you bringing into the studio right now? What sonics are you drawing inspiration from? What wells? If it's not music, what is inspiring Larry June right now?
So what I do is, you know, so I don't do studio. So what I first do is I clean my house up very neatly. You know what I'm saying? I vacuum my floor, got a good Dyson. You know what I'm saying? I wipe down my counters. You know what I'm saying? I make me a fresh tea. Hot though, hot tea. Maybe a little Earl Grey tea or a chamomile. You know what I'm talking about? I'll do 10 push-ups. I might ride my bike for like a mile or two. And I get the inspiration and I get in the booth and I start spitting like I'm missing a tooth. You know what I'm saying? Yes, sir.
That's really real. Mm-hmm. That's really real.
Yeah.
Okay, so what is in your day-to-day routine? Because it seems like making sure your home is in the right order. So what's your taking care of yourself? What's your self-care routine look like?
Since we on Rolling Stone, I gotta let y'all know, man. For everybody that want a feature, man, I only rap 3 hours a day. You know what I'm saying? I only rap 3 hours a day. I get in the studio at 6 o'clock. And I'm done around 9 o'clock in the morning. You know what I'm saying? So if you don't hit me between them hours, it can get ugly. You know what I'm saying? So I rap 3 hours a day. The rest of my day, I do regular shit. I ride my bike. I go to the grocery store. I spend time with my son. I wash my cars. I buy shoes and shit. Drink smoothies. And it's all the regular shit because I don't really like rapping too long. It gives me anxiety. You know what I'm saying? So if I feel energy and I'm in the studio, I knock it down right there. Matter of fact, sometimes, though, it might take me 3 days to do one song because I might just do, like, the intro of that motherfucker then the next day. Mm-hmm. But the thing is consistency. So if I do 3 hours a day every day for 365 days, I just did outstanding numbers. You know what I'm saying? It ain't what you do, it's how you do it. You know what I'm saying? So as long as you stay consistent with it, you go win every time. I only do 3 hours a day. I'm not a rapper, man.
I'm with that arithmetic right there.
Yeah.
3 hours a day. 365 days in a year. That's more than a lot of people can say.
Yeah, yeah.
Because for those 3 hours, you are focused.
And look, think about it like this, though, because you want to make sure you're working at your best mind quality when your mind is working the best. We go to jobs and we spend 9 hours a day doing something for somebody else. I can invest 3 hours a day into my craft and then take time to live my life at the same time. I'm winning. I don't like looking at laptops too long. I don't like being around niggas in the studio too long or smoking hella weed in the room. 30 niggas dancing, females I don't even know. I don't rock like that. I'm here to do numbers and keep it moving. You know what I'm saying?
Mental health is wealth right here. Mm-hmm. When did you find this balance?
Man, you know, I used to live a different lifestyle where it wasn't so much peaceful. So my peace was taking drugs and riding bikes and doing shit to elevate my mind. And in between time, I would still try to record. I always kept music in mind. Like, I know I ain't living 100% correctly, but I know that music eventually can do something for me. So I was putting hours in back then. And then when I first got my real opportunity, I just kept that program going. And as it is what it is. It ain't really nothing to it.
Yeah. I
love that. That's my best feeling. I feel like the man. When I wake up early, get that jog in or ride my bike for a second and get a little, even if it's like one part of the song, I just feel like I did numbers that day. You know what I mean?
One thing that everybody knows about you is style is very, very important.
Yeah,
your musical style, but also your personal style. Mm-hmm. Has that always been the case, or is that something that you've really tapped into creatively as you've grown?
Man, I've been putting that shit on my whole life. You know what I'm saying? My mom kept me in that shit when I was a little one. You know what I'm saying? The fresh Jordans. Pops did too. And I just grew up to be this person, man. I got to stand fresh is one of my real main, you know what I'm saying, priorities in life. I sleep with the polo pajamas on, you know what I'm saying, fresh socks. And that's just how I'm coming, y'all. Yeah, I keep fresh socks. I'm letting niggas know, man, buy some motherfucking new socks. Don't be sitting there tripping out with the female doing and all the shit. You ain't buy no new boxes in 3 weeks. Niggas got doodle stains, all the good shit, but you worried about the wrong shit. You know what I'm saying? Buy some new motherfucking boxes, man. Yes, Lord. Sock it to me.
Look them in the eye and tell them, because some people need to hear that. They didn't hear that.
Buy some motherfucking boxes. Buy some motherfucking socks, man. Don't be tripping out the female if you ain't bought no socks in 6 months, man. I swear to Bob. Sock it to me.
That's very important.
Yeah. That's some game for you.
That needs to be a mantra for somebody, because somebody really needed to hear that.
Yeah, man. The nigga be having the same drawers from 2007.
With the holes in it.
You got holes in your nigga. Like, if you ever see a hole in your sock, go buy some new socks, man.
It should never get to that point, regardless.
That's very important. You know what I'm saying? You see these motherfuckers, I ain't go, you know. I did the, you feel me, you know what I'm saying? The Gucci niggas.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Slight dumb investment, but I had to do it. You know what I'm saying? Very peaceful, you know what I'm saying? But that's it.
What are some staples in your closet right now? What is a Larry June staple.
And, you know, I got a whole lot of Midnight Organic unreleased shit. You know what I'm saying?
Now, that mess is hard.
That's my brand, you know what I'm saying? I started that a few years ago and shit. And I got a few Louis pieces, you know, limited edition Jordans and shit from the 90s. You know, it's very casual. I wear regular shit everybody can get, but I just got it at a good time at a good price. You know what I'm saying? So I keep it simple, nothing too crazy. I don't do the Versace t-shirts and shit. You know, I keep the fresh white tee. I got two boxes of these. I wear a new one every day.
I like that.
You know
that.
What I'm saying? I got to make sure it stay fresh. And that shit, it is what it is. Sock it to me.
When can we expect a full project? What's the music looking like? Yep. Like, give me something. I need to know because we're craving.
I got full projects done.
Yeah.
I got a project dropping next month. You know, I ain't going to say the name. Me and Alchemist done with our album. You know what I'm saying? Me and Cardo got one in the tuck. You know what I'm saying? And we just keeping it moving. You know what I'm saying? Like a wheelchair. Mm.
If you could give me a hint with like emojis, what are we going to expect from this new album?
From this album?
Mm-hmm.
Man, that's a good one. An orange.
An orange?
A bicycle, you know what I'm saying? And a numbers emoji, you know what I'm saying?
I feel like that's just you to a T. That just describes you.
I rode bikes throughout the process, you know what I'm saying? I traveled a lot. I went overseas, so maybe a couple overseas flags. And man, you know, this album actually went with 18 songs.
Okay.
My biggest project I did in my career. So, which I don't really give a fuck. I do 5 songs, but you know, I just had extra ones, so I said, fuck it. Let's toss it on there, you know what I mean?
Well, it seems like you've lived a lot of life, you've done a lot of things, seen a lot of things, so it makes sense that you got a project that sounds like it's gonna round it out.
Yeah, I wanted to give the people this time something substantial. You know what I mean? And I said, fuck it. Usually I'd be like, I don't wanna put that on there. I gave it to him, you know what I mean? Gave him a little extra of it, you know what I'm saying?
I'm ready to savor it.